Elementor Pro or Divi. In this video, I'm going to talk about the differences so you can make a well-thought, deliberate decision about which one to choose. I first want to talk to you about the learning curve. Some people say Elementor Pro is too hard to learn, others say Divi is too hard to learn. That is all not true. In fact, as with all skills, it just takes time to learn to build a website. If you do want to have a website that you can just click and or just use a template and change it, we'll talk about later about the templates, but that's actually not what you want. What you want is a tailor-made website completely created by yourself so that it's absolutely unique. Does it take time to learn? Of course. Is it difficult? It's not that difficult if you know your way around a web browser and you have the right teacher to help you learn Elementor and learn Divi. So for the score, I'm gonna give both builders a 9 out of 10 because they're both very good learnable if you learn it from the right people. Now let's talk about pricing. Elementor Pro has a yearly subscription plan. You might think $59 a year is the best one, but no, you only have one website and only 50 of the Pro widgets. What you actually always need is the 82 Pro widgets, up to 3 websites, for just $100 a year. $100 a year is not that much, in my opinion, if you get a good, solid system that works excellent out of the box, and that is what it actually does. Now, if you want to buy Elementor Pro, you can absolutely help me a lot by creating these free videos to follow my affiliate link. It's in the comment section and the description of this video. But with Divi, you also have a yearly subscription plan of $90 a year, but then you can use Divi on unlimited websites. That's a big difference with Elementor Pro. But there's another big difference. If you hit this switch, you get a lifetime deal. That means for $250, you can build unlimited websites with Divi for the rest of your life, and you also get new updates. And updates are really important with Divi as, well, we're about to see that their builder is a bit old. If you follow my affiliate link, you get 24 hours discount of 10% on the purchase of Divi Lifetime or Divi Yearly. Now, there's also such a thing as the Divi Pro. If you buy this one, you also get Divi AI, unlimited text, image, and code generation. You could also access to the Divi Cloud Storage, which may be useful if you use kind of create a lot of Divi websites. And you have Divi VIP, which means 24/7 premium support in 30 minutes or less. We're going to talk about support later on. This might be interesting, but if you want to buy a lifetime license, then you have to renew for $220 a year for just Divi IA Cloud and VIP. I personally never use the Divi Pro license as I don't have a team working on different kind of projects at the same time, and I don't use AI that much in building websites. So for the score, I would give Divi a 10 out of 10 because of the lifetime license, but I also agree that the $99 a year is actually not that much when you can create beautiful websites which is generating your money, or you can live your dream by doing so. So with that said, I give Elementor an 8 out of 10. Now for the next thing, I want to talk to you about the development. Because a lifetime license may seem very good, the problem is the cash flow of the company. Because all the customers just buy this one-time license for the rest of their lives, how are they gonna keep paying all the developers? And that's something we can see really good now in the development of the next Divi versions. We are still waiting for a way faster interface of Divi 5. I've created a bunch of videos about Divi 5, the newest releases. They are completely missing the boat. I need to develop websites right now. And if I have to choose between this builder or I go to Elementor, which is way faster and a better UI than Divi. Talking about the development speed, I'm gonna give Divi a 5 out of 10 because I'm not very happy about the speed of development. Elementor, I'm gonna give them a 9 because they keep pushing out these updates and new features every single time. Now let's talk about the difference in widgets and modules between Elementor Pro and Divi out of the box. In my experience, what I notice is that the widgets of Elementor are just a little bit way more developed. For example, a testimonial carousel is just standard in Elementor. But if I go to my Divi website, I cannot create anything like a carousel because it's not in here. You have to use a slider, post slider, slider, video slider, but you cannot create a carousel with reviews. Just a very simple, basic thing that we all need. Of course, you can buy plugins to do this, and I've done this for a lot of my client websites, but it's not natively there. And after all these years, I don't know why they have that, because in Elementor, it's just in here. Just drag and drop it in here, and then you can create this amazing slider with all these different items, so you can create and customize a review slider. And there are way more things like that, which I think that the Elementor builder is just developed further than Divi. But not only that, Elementor Pro also comes with a pop-up builder, something that is to Divi completely unknown. So I need another plugin for that. Just those little things that makes your life when building your website way more easier with Elementor. But not only that, as you can see in my Elementor user preferences, I have also the dark theme to build my website in, and you can change it whatever you want. I know it's just something small, but it's all these small things that makes your life building your website a lot more easier. Divi doesn't have that. You're just stuck with this purple and white box. So when I go to design and I go to my text, for example, then the text font weight. Look at this. Light, semi bold, bold, ultra bold. In Elementor, you go to typography and you can choose the weight. Look at this. Divi only has global colors, but with Elementor, it's just a little bit nicer, because when I click on this one, you will go over here and you can see that my custom colors, I have these colors and this one, and I can just change the names, add colors in here. It just works so well. With Divi, if you want to use global colors, you can just click over here, click on this icon, and then you can not give them a name, anything. You have to edit them over here. You have to press this button, choose a color, and then you have to press on this plus icon. We have to do it again, and there it is. If I now want to delete it, I can go in here and delete them, and there's my global color is gone. I know it's just a small thing, but it just feels like Elementor has done more hours in developing than Divi. And before you start commenting, Divi 5 does not change anything about the functionality of Divi 4, which I'm showing you right now. Check my videos about Divi 5. It's all exactly the same, only for the speed. Now, a very big difference that made me look way more to Elementor than Divi is because of the way containers work. Now, Divi still works with sections, rows, and inside the rows you can place modules, and you can change the row to whatever column you need. Now, this might look very great and easy to use, but if you start using Elementor and you start working with all the containers, then you might find out that this is actually way more flexible. Look at this. For example, this row in here. I can create the column. I can make it vertical. I can reverse it. I can reverse it upside down. I can make it horizontal. Then I can justify the content to put them all on start, put them all with space between or space evenly. It is so easy. Also, the alignment of items. If I click on this one and I go to style, vertical position in here, just these simple things are not available within Divi. This makes your life so much easier when you're building websites. You don't want to know how much I enjoyed creating this Elementor webshop better than Divi, because it's just way more well thought out. The details just works excellent. So for the scores, I'm gonna give Divi a 5 on this one, because I don't like what they're doing with the widgets and the modules. It's still not changing, even in Divi 5. Don't get me in the comments and, oh, Divi 5 is better. No, it's not. See all my videos about Divi 5 in comparison with Divi 4. They are still light years away from Elementor, unfortunately. And I'm gonna give Elementor a 9 out of 10 because I really like how they create their widgets and they just work. Then let's talk about extensions or third-party apps for your Divi or Elementor websites. Elegant Themes has a marketplace for Divi where you can buy more than 1700 extensions, layout, and child themes for your Divi website. So whatever you need, you can find it in here. For example, the Table Maker is very popular, but also the Divi Menus, which you can use to create any kind of menu within your Divi website. Because again, the standard Divi module is just not that extensive and not that good. Now, Elementor also has a lot of third-party apps and child themes and add-ons. They all have this, but not via the Elementor website themselves. If you look at this, you can click on them, but then you go to the website of the developers and you can buy the add-on and plugins for your Elementor website. Now, Elementor has thousands of child themes, add-ons, plugins you can find anywhere on the internet, buy them and put them in your Elementor website. This actually works also the same as with Divi, really great. Both page builders actually have a very big resource of add-ons and child themes, so I'm both gonna give them a 9 out of 10. Now let's talk about AI integration for your website. If you do create a lot of websites, AI might be useful for you. If you're just creating one website, then you might want to skip this part as it's not that very interesting for you. Go to the next subject. But Elementor has two different kinds of subscriptions, the starter and the power. It just gives you more credits, 18,000 or 50,000 for $35 a year or $99 a year. Now, Divi only has one AI plan, which is $260 a year. And it will give you an unlimited amount of text, image, and code generation from within Divi. Now, I didn't test out the quality of these AI subscriptions. If you did and you have experience with them, drop them down in the comments. I'm really interested in if they did a good job for your content. As for the score, they both give AI integration and they both have a reasonable pricing range. But the difference is Elementor has two pricing plans and Divi only one. So I'm gonna give Elementor an 8 out of 10 and Divi a 7. Then we're gonna talk about layouts or templates. When you start a new page with Divi, you can choose to use their pre-made layouts and they have a lot of them. The current counter is a 351 layout packs and within each layout, there are actually different kind of pages. So if I click on this one, you can see all these different layouts inside of this pack. And this one you can use for free because they're already paid inside of your Divi license. So you can use any one of these layouts and put them in your website, change them, rearrange them, edit them, whatever you want. It is extremely big. And they're even creating new layout packs every other week, I believe. So there are a lot of layouts within your Divi license, which is actually a very impressive thing. Now, Elementor does have slightly the same thing as Divi, but there's a big difference. If I go to the Elementor library, for example, I want a swimwear shop website and I really like it, and then I have to pay $10 a month extra to use this theme on my website. Aren't there free things? Yes, there are. You can go to your website, just click on here. And there's also some block library inside of Elementor. And with this, you can just search or go through all these different kind of blocks or elements, which you can use to create your website. However, they are just generated for just one section and you can put it in your website and build on all these sections together to create your entire website. If you do, however, want to have an entire website, then you can download child themes from other third-party designers and there are a bunch of them. But what I do like about this is that you get wireframes from Elementor, which you can just add into your page and you only have to change all the, everything inside of your wireframe. So this way you can create your own website, but you have the wireframe already in your website so that all your websites don't look exactly the same and you can create your own style using a wireframe. So for the score, the 350 layout packs of Divi is just phenomenal. Absolutely a 10 out of 10. With Elementor, you still have to do a lot of things yourself. But when talking about templates, Elementor only scores a 7 out of 10. So let's talk about support. Both page builders provide an excellent support system. As you know by now, Divi also offers a 30 minutes max waiting time for your support within a pro support license. However, I've never used that before. And as you can see, I've used multiple times the help from Divi and they just point out things that I didn't look or I just need someone else to help me and just another pair of eyes to look at the problem. And frankly, they always fix my problem. every single time. So their support is actually pretty good and they go very far with their solutions. Most of the times I also get custom CSS snippets that I can put in and it just fixes my problem immediately. Or they just tell me some things that I didn't know or that I just didn't see. So their support is actually excellent and I'm pretty happy with it. Do I now have to wait longer because I don't have the Pro support license? In my experience, yes, you do have to wait sometimes 2 to 3 hours before getting a response. And if that is very important to you, you can buy the Pro support. With Elementor, you also have a support system and you can chat with first the virtual assistants, going to send you through some different kind of knowledge website pages, the same with Divi, but then you get a real person on it and they will actually help you pretty fast. But the difference is I don't have to wait 3 to 4 hours. They're just here within 15 minutes and they actually help me solve the problem with different kind of articles or with just screenshots that help me out to change things that I just didn't thought of. So for the score, both page builders have excellent support, but I don't like the idea that I have to pay for support while I'm already paying Divi for maybe a yearly subscription. So I'm gonna give Divi a 6 out of 10 and Elementor an 8 out of 10 for their support because they both help me, but yes, there's a difference in time. Now let's talk about an important topic, speed. We distinguish two kinds of speed on the front end, so how visitors experience the speed of your website, and on the back end, so how fast can you build your website yourself. Now on the front end, Divi is just slower than Elementor Pro. Numbers don't lie, I have used a lot of plugins to speed up websites just because Divi is way slower than Elementor Pro. Do they fix this in Divi 5? Yes, most of it is fixed in Divi 5, but you still need a caching plugin to speed up your Elementor website and your Divi website. But out of the box, Elementor Pro is faster than Divi. Then let's talk about the backend. On the backend, editing with Elementor Pro is like a breath of fresh air when compared to Divi, because Divi is just really a slow builder. If you want to see this in action, I've compared Divi 5 with Divi 4 on the backend and on the front end, but on the backend you can really see a big difference. It is just really slow. You have to click on it. Look at all these animations. All these things, they just fade in and it takes time. But also what takes a lot of time is when you change something inside of a module, you have to save it down here. You have to save it and then save your page over there. With Elementor, you don't have that. You just go into here, you edit things. You don't have to press update all the time. So that actually speeds up building your website like 10x. I'm not exaggerating. I can build Elementor Pro websites way faster than with Divi. Is that gonna change in the next update? Yes, Divi 5, the backend speed is way faster than Divi 4. However, in my opinion, Divi 5 should have already arrived 2 years ago. So we're still stuck with Divi 4. Is it slow? Yes, it's extremely slow. So on this point in 2024, I'm gonna give, in regards to speed, I'm gonna give Divi a 4 because I really don't like the speed and I do like the Elementor Pro speed. So I'm gonna give it an 8 because we still need a caching plugin, of course, to get the most out of the speed of our website. Now let's talk about resources, documentations and tutorials found around the internet with both page builders. Now we can be very easy about this. Both have very good documentation on their websites and also both have very lot tutorials around on YouTube. However, as Elementor Pro is being used by a lot of more people, which actually create more tutorials, there is way more tutorials about Elementor Pro, good tutorials, than good tutorials about Divi. Because most Divi tutorials out there are just not that great. And there are just way more Elementor tutorials to be found on YouTube, for example. So I'm gonna give Elementor a 9 out of 10 and Divi an 8 out of 10. Now it's time to add up all the grades I've been given to Elementor Pro and to Divi, and these are the scores. Congratulations, Elementor Pro. In my opinion, right now, Elementor Pro is the best choice to build your websites in 2024. Now, if I miss something that you think I should really talk about in comparison, drop them down in the comments. I'm very happy to go on and discuss it even further in the comments. If you want to see more WordPress tutorials about Divi or about Elementor, subscribe to this channel and you're always in good to go.